Hello, this is Rebecca Ventrini, and I'm here to show you how to create custom metadata templates in Lightroom 5. So, from Lightroom 5, we have already imported our images from our memory card, and preferably saved them to some folders on an external hard drive. We are currently in the library module. You can select as many images as you want at this point, or none at all. We're just going to create some templates. Over here on the right-hand panel, go ahead and expand the metadata tab, if it's not already expanded. And right here where it says preset, go ahead and click on these arrows to open up that drop-down menu and choose edit presets. Now you can create as many presets as you want. We're going to go ahead and just create a general preset that has our contact information on it so that we can apply that to every single image that we import. Go ahead and hit the check none button down here, and this window can actually be expanded if that works better for you. We don't need any of this basic info in this template. Same with the camera info or the IPTC content. We do want this IPTC copyright info. So under the copyright field, I recommend writing all rights reserved. You can even get more specific and write something like all rights reserved for artist or all rights reserved for content creator. You can put the same information here under right usage terms. Copyright info URL is going to be your personal URL for your website, like your portfolio or your business's website. Make sure you put in the http://, so that will actually make this a live link. If you start your URL with just the www, or for my example, beccajess.com, then it won't actually be an active link. You have to have the beginning of it here. Then, for IPTC creator, you definitely wanted this information because you want to have credit for your work. Go ahead and write your name there. Type your name there. It's up to you if you want to include your address. You can include the city if you'd like to, and the state if you want to. This is all your personal preference. Zip code, etc., creator country, your phone number. I'm going to go ahead and put in the email of my company in case somebody finds this online and they want to use it. Over at Atomic Graphics.com. All right, creator website. Now, I know this might seem different than the IPTC copyright URL that we put here. This is totally up to you. Sometimes the creator is actually somebody different than the company that owns the copyright. Say you hire an intern and they shot the images, or you're the intern, you're working for a different company. So that's how, that's where you can, you know, specify that info. For the creator website, I'm just going to put the same thing as I put above. All right. And creator job title, same thing. You can put photographer, CEO, whatever it is that you'd like to put. So that's all the information that we really need for this specific template. I'm going to go ahead and click Done. And save new changes as a preset. Hit Save As. And then title the preset whatever you want. I'm going to call it Name 2013. And Create. All right. So now I'm going to go ahead and select this image, and I'm going to apply this preset that we just created. And you just saw a little thing pop up here. It went really quickly since we only had one image selected. And now that information has been applied. You can see right here, creator, Rebecca Jess, copyrights, all reserved. And then it also keeps the original information, the camera information, here in your metadata as well. So if you wanted to, you can go ahead and add another preset that had to do with maybe this job that you did, or an experiment that, you know, you like. In this image, I was experimenting with using my flash outside to kind of overexpose the sky. And let's say I had 300 images and I just wanted to go back and reference, you know, the camera metadata or whatever I did in that shot, then I could apply that preset to that entire shoot. As you can see right here, I have one for an event that I shot this year, and I had thousands of images that I had to apply this to. and actually incorporate that company that I shot the images for, their information in there as well. So the sky's the limit on however many presets you want to apply to a set of images or one image, and some of it will override the previous template that you applied, or if those fields were blank, then nothing will be overwritten. All right, let me know if you have any questions. Thanks so much for watching.